Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to design a cluster monitor using zookeeper. And here, we are not just going to design the cluster monitor using zookeeper, but we are also going to implement using Java and Maven project. So let's quickly get started. So here is the problem statement that you have multiple servers, and these can be any of your server serving REST API or whatnot. It can be a crawling service. It can be anything. And you want to monitor them in the sense that you want to make sure that these services are up and running. So these are the servers and these are the cluster of servers. You can have n numbers of servers and you have a monitor and you can call it as cloud controller or anything. And what it does is that it needs to check the status of all of these servers. And if any of the server goes down, it needs to take some action. That some action can be anything. It can be informing you, alerting you. It could be spawning a new server. It can be anything. But this is the requirement. And we want to design this cloud controller or a cluster monitor. And we are going to see how we can do that with the help of zookeeper. But before moving to zookeeper, let's think about the approaches which you could take to design such system. Would you have a polling-based mechanism or will you have an event-based mechanism? So let's try to understand that. The first is that you can think of around the health check APIs that you can just poll the servers and see the status of all of these servers every 5 seconds or so. And if the server goes down, then you inform someone. And the other is the event-based system where the zookeeper comes into the picture. So we'll see both. We'll first see the polling based approach and we will check why this approach is not feasible in many of the cases and it is limited. And then we'll also see the event based approach, that how zookeeper solves this problem. I also wanted to talk about this use of zookeeper in designing the cluster monitor. When I was doing research of this particular video, I found that this concept is not just theoretical, that you will be reading and you can forget and this is just for seeing how zookeeper would have helped, but it is also used in many places. I could find a link to a Yahoo white paper where they mentioned that they use zookeeper to monitor the cluster, and likewise there were a few links here and there where they said that in Twitter also it is being used. I link the link to the Yahoo one because that's what I could find, and it uses the same principle approach of event based or having some nodes. So the approach would be same and we will get on to the details with that. Now let's talk about what's the problem with the polling based approach. So there are multiple servers. One server I have mentioned in red color, that is the server which is not healthy. And this cloud controller or the server monitor is polling every 5 seconds, that I'll poll all of these servers every 5 seconds and whichever server is unable to respond, I will mark it as unhealthy and I'll take some actions, as simple as that. But there are a few problems with that approach. The first problem is that what if this controller or the monitor goes down? What if you have a controller and it makes API call every 5 seconds and one fine day it went down? So if it goes down, what are you going to do? Your monitoring will go down. So you can't have single point of failure for monitoring everything. So you need a cluster of servers of cloud controllers, basically having multi-node cloud controller, let's say 3 nodes, 4 nodes, 5 nodes. And then there are problems in coordinating between those controllers, that what if you are monitoring each server by 2 controllers. Let's say there are 2 controllers monitoring server 1 and you have distributed in a way that each server is monitored by 2 or 3. Then you need to decide that if one of the node is saying this server is up and the other node is saying the server is down, then what are you going to do? You can think about majority consensus and all those things, but that is something which you have to deal with yourself. I mean, you can do that by having multiple nodes and then you can have a logic that whatever majority gives, you will consider that. But again, even in those cases, you will have to aggregate the response of the multiple cloud controllers and then based on the majority, you have to decide something. So there is a problem of coordinating between multiple nodes, even in the simplest approach which you can think of. So that's why the zookeeper comes into the picture. So now we'll move on to the zookeeper solution. So this is the solution which we will consider. And for this solution, I would recommend that you look into my previous videos of zookeeper playlist, because there are a few concepts which I'm going to talk about, which have been talked about in the previous videos. These are the servers which you want to monitor, and we will have a zookeeper server with us. You will install and set up a zookeeper server, and then you will have a monitor. That is, you have a cluster monitor where you can do a bunch of things. The best thing here is that the problem of availability of the monitor is now given to zookeeper. Zookeeper is a highly available system, and it can have a cluster of nodes. You can have multiple nodes within zookeeper. Here I have represented with just one box, but if you see my previous videos, you will see that you can have a cluster of nodes. So the problem of availability is given to zookeeper, and these monitors, you can have as many monitors as you want, will just connect to the zookeeper. So they will get the data from the zookeeper server. They will not have to deal individual servers, and they will always get the aggregated data. That is, how many servers are up, how many servers are down, what these servers are doing. So they don't have to bother about the individual servers. So the chances of conflict between the different monitors would be less. So it is not going to happen that one monitor is giving you one data and the other monitor is giving you other data. They will mostly be giving you the same data. So in this way, this will be more fault tolerant compared to the previous approach. So that's the plan. That what we are going to have is that we'll have a Java code for this server, and within those servers we'll have a daemon client, and that daemon client will create an ephemeral node in the zookeeper server. So what is ephemeral node? Again, please check out my previous video. I will link in the description. So this server one will create an ephemeral node name as /members/server1. The server two will create a ephemeral node with name /members/server2. And the third one will create an ephemeral node with path or name /member/server3. So whenever a server comes up, it will create a ephemeral node with its own name. This name can be configurable, especially the last part, but the base path will be same. And all of these will create this ephemeral node. So what's the nature of this node is that the moment this server goes down, this node will get deleted from the zookeeper server. Now this monitor, what it will do, it will watch for all the children for the node called as /members. You can again see how the hierarchy of the zookeeper server looks like. It looks like a tree-based structure. Here, what this zookeeper monitor is going to do is that it will watch for any changes done in the node called as /members. Now, the moment any of the server goes down, let's say server 2 went down, within a few seconds, this node will get deleted from the server because this connection broke. Or there are a few conditions like the server deliberately closed its connection, etc. So the moment this happened, this particular node will get deleted. The moment this node gets deleted, the cluster monitor will get a callback, a watcher event from the zookeeper server that, hey, the children of the node /members got changed. So the moment this message comes to the zookeeper monitor will act on it, and it will make the fresh get children call. And in the fresh get children call, it will come to know that earlier these were the servers and now only these two are the server. So this means that the server 2 got deleted. So it can compare with its previous state, which was there already when the server got started. And the moment any of the nodes get deleted, it will get a message that this node got deleted. And based on that node getting deleted event, it will make a fresh call to get the children of the nodes. And based on that message, it can act that this node got deleted and this is not deleted. So this is a simple approach where the onus of the availability is on Zookeeper, and you are working on an event-based approach where when you watch for any changes, you get a callback that is called as Zookeeper Watchers, and based on that you can act. So now we'll quickly move on to the coding part and we'll see how to code this. This is the sample code for servers to be monitored and the Zookeeper monitor. And this is a Java-based project. I'm using IntelliJ as the IDE. I'm using a Maven-based project. How you can create a project is using IntelliJ. You go here, create a new project. And when you create a new project, you make sure that it is a Maven type of projects. So it is very easy to configure. You can search online how to create a Java Maven based project and you will see it's very simple. So that's what I have already done to save your time. And in my dependency management system, that is here, it is done using Maven. I have added the dependency of the Zookeeper client. So here it's a Zookeeper library which I have added, and using this Zookeeper library, I will connect to the Zookeeper server installed on my machine. We'll first go to the Zookeeper servers to be monitored code. So whichever server I want to monitor, if they are up or not, I will write this code which will run all the time. For the simplicity, I have done thread.sleep for very long time, but there are more cleaner way to do this. Just that for the demo purpose, I didn't want to make the code complex. So I chose this approach. Let me quickly show you the code, how it looks like. What we'll do is that we will create an ID for each of the servers running. You could have IP address, port, etc. Basically the identifier of each of the servers, so that when you get alert that the server X went down, so that server X needs to have some ID. There are again more cleaner ways to generate the ID of a server, but I'm using the simplest one, that your server will have some ID. Then what I'm doing is I'm connecting to the local Zookeeper server, and that is running on localhost 2181. The moment I connect to the server and my server is up and running, I create a node under the /members/ID. And you can give any data you want to, it doesn't matter. So here the data can be anything. I gave as id.getBytes, but it can be anything. I am using allow everyone access control because we are not talking about access control in this video. So I want to keep it simple. And this is the important part. I am creating an ephemeral node. So this ephemeral node means that it is not a permanent node. It means that if my server goes down, this node will automatically get deleted from the Zookeeper server. So Zookeeper server will keep monitoring the session from my client. And the moment this session goes off, the Zookeeper server will delete this node. And then I am just logging the response. It's not much. That's how the thing is, that I create a node, and till the time my server is up, this node will be existing. And the moment my server goes down, this node will go down. And now we'll go to the Zookeeper monitoring code. So this Zookeeper monitoring code will keep on monitoring the changes in the children of this node/members. In my main method of my Zookeeper monitoring code, I am connecting to the same Zookeeper server, and here I am adding a watcher. In my Zookeeper servers to be monitored, this value was null because I was not planning to watch for any changes, but here I am adding watcher. And this is what I'm going to do here, that the moment any changes happened on any of the nodes being watched, this code will get triggered. And what this code does is that it prints the path and it prints the event type. So with the help of this, you would get an event that, hey, this particular event has happened. And here, when you start a process, you can have a local variable to have a previous state in memory, and then you can take a diff. I have not done that again to take a diff between two lists. That's easy. And here I'm creating a node. So if the node doesn't exist, let's create a node. And then again, I'm sleeping my process for a very long time. Let me increase the time even more so that it doesn't stop when I'm running the code. And here, what I'm doing is my code will create a watch on the children of a particular node. So it will give me a list of children. When my code starts, this particular code will run and it will give me the list of children of a particular node. And whenever any change happens to that node, this code will hit and I will get the list of children again using the same value, and then I can compare with the previous value. So here I'll just focus on how to figure out what are the changes done, and you can interpret that very easily. So now let's quickly move on to the terminal and launch our zookeeper server. This is the command to start the zookeeper server, and you can see my zookeeper server has started. Now I'll go to my Java project and I'll build my project. You can see that my jar has been built. Now I'll go to the terminal. I have opened four terminals and I have already set up my commands. So the terminal 1, 2 and 3 are for the servers to be monitored, and the fourth one is for zookeeper monitor. So that's how I have created four different terminals, and this monitor will give me the data around which server is up and which server is not. So let me first start my zookeeper monitor. And you can see that my monitor has started. So initially it gave me the error that slash members node does not exist. But remember, there was a code to create a node if it doesn't exist. So that's what happened, that now the node would be created. Now let me launch the zookeeper servers. So I launch first zookeeper server, and this is the ID of the server which I was logging. And now you can see in my logs that this is the list of the server. And in my logs, it does mention that the node children got changed and this is the fresh list. Now if I launch second server, and you can see the ID of the second server is B6 something, and you can see on my server the B6 something got added, and the event was again the node children changed. So whenever the children of the node gets changed, the event gets called in the zookeeper server, and there you can see the list of the server. So this is the list for now, that is server 1 and server 2. Now what I'll do is I will launch the third server, and the moment I launch my third server, now you can see three space separated values. The third one is 16 something. And you can see that 16 something is also present in my terminal. Now what I'll do is I'll stop one of the servers and we'll see that the list got shrunk. So let me do a control C on server 1. And it will take some time based on the heartbeat of the server. And then it will show you that the particular node got killed. Let's wait a bit. And you can see my new list is just 2. Now let me stop the second server, and we will again wait for the zookeeper monitor to react. So it takes some time to get that done. And now you can see that I have just one child present, and if I stop the last one as well, so again the event will be called and the last one as well will get stopped. And you can see that the number of children are 0. Thanks for watching this video. I hope this video would have made sense for you. You should check out the code that how this zookeeper client is getting connected to the server, and how these monitors are watching for the changes of any children, and how this whole monitoring is working. I will upload this code in the link, and please check out and let me know the feedback, how you liked it. It really makes a difference. Till the next time, bye.